It's great to be here again with Jess and our first guest, Mitch Tambo. Yay. Let's get straight into it.
Great to see you.
Mitch, is always great to see you. Mitch, he's one of Australia's most talented entertainers with a debut album that raced up the charts. And he really made his mark performing with loved Aussie songs in his Gamilaroi language?
Gamilaroi, yes.
There we go. Yeah. Want to learn? We have to ask questions, folks. Earlier this year, he released his version of the Ice House classic Great Southern Land, which also features Ryan Reagan singing in both Gamilaroi and English. Take a look here. Awesome as that. Yeah, so good. And Mitch, it's great to have you here in the studio as well. You've also got a brand new single out, which is great. Sorry, I'll get you talking in a second. Let's take a listen to it now. Awesome.
Yeah.
Now, finally, say something. Tell us about the song, Mitch. Great to see you.
Yeah, I'm here. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm here. Studio 10. No, it's great to be here. Yugal Yulu-gi basically means song dance, and it's a song that's really about being with your loved ones, your community, your village, if you like, out under the open night sky and being lost in song and dance and letting go of all the woes and pressures and stresses of the world. But then the posing question being that the sun will rise tomorrow, and when it rises, will you walk in your newfound freedom into that fresh chapter of life, or will you carry on the burdens of the world?
Oh, beautiful.
How important is that? We've lost connectivity, haven't we, with our neighbours?
Oh, totally. I mean, connection's everything, and we have. We've lost connectivity and we've connected all of our devices, but that human connectivity is definitely sort of fading away. So I think it's so important to get with your loved ones and to celebrate the wins in life and also just to let go, because we carry so many stresses and anxieties and things like that. So to be able to put a song out with that intent and message, I think, is really important.
Beautiful. Fox Sports has picked up the song to play with the Indigenous round. What does that mean to you?
Oh, it's great. I love the clip and to see all the big fellas out there running in slow-mo. And I'm like, no.
They just say, they're doing a bit of Baywatch action.
Yeah. No, it's great.
We thank you so much, because not only are you displaying your culture, but you're able to help us teach our children about such a beautiful culture with such a special message. And we can't thank you enough for bringing that to the public eye. It's also National Sorry Day, and you've recently spoken, which I can't believe, about the online hate that you receive for advocating that. Can you tell us a little bit more about that and how it affects you?
Yeah, look, I mean, as soon as I put up on my story that I'd be here this morning, it just starts. It's all the time. I think this morning I got the fool himself, Feather Boy, and I was like, wow, if I was a superhero...
Yeah.
All the way from the streets of Tamworth.
Feather Boy.
You got to flip it and say,
I love that.
That's right.
Yeah. I like
the power.
It.
Until Feather Boy gets taken for it like a pillow, then Feather Boy's in a little bit of trouble, you know.
Some marketing for a beautiful pillow company. But yeah, look, it happens frequently, and I've just decided now to not let it affect me, but to flip it and turn it into, you know, my power, and that is to educate people, to put it out there and to let, you know, the next generation know that, you know, you don't have to sacrifice who you are, and you can rock your traditional dress or whatever it is, but you can be authentically yourself, and there's nothing wrong with that. So it's not to sort of get people's comments and then return the favour by airing them out, but it's to educate. And I feel like if you're bold enough to make comments of that level, then surely you can be accountable too if people decide to share that with their following or whoever. So.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You're most definitely right, yeah. And you're making such a huge impact culturally as well for everyone. A show that's really close to my own heart is Burn the Floor. I danced on that show for 10, 12 years, I think it was, as well. And you're going to be joining this show. Tell us a little bit about that, because this is very, very exciting, not just for the dance world, but for all the world, I guess.
Well, Tristan, I don't know if I'll be burning the floor for my dance moves. I do have a few moves. I don't know if they're ballroom. But, yeah, I'm really looking forward to the collaboration, to be able to bring my music into the ballroom space. And burn the floor, I've got a really big heart around breaking stereotypes and confinements around dance, and they've seen that within my music and message what I'm trying to do, so it seemed like a natural fit. So we're hitting the road second half of this year to do a national tour, and it's going to be electrifying. I think it's going to be great.
Just amazing.
What was that thing? Sorry, what was that... What's the show called at the top there? I don't know what that means, sorry, and I need to ask Wollumbar, the question.
Yes. Wollumbar Yulu-gi, so strong dance.
Nice.
Strong dance.
Yeah. I like the questions. Yeah.
Now, you're also performing at the SCG tonight. Do you love a big crowd? You've done a few.
I'm ready. I think. I shouldn't get cocky, should I? But no, look, it's a blessing, and the blessing
but you've
is.
You've got to be pumped.
You've got to be pumped and grateful and all of that stuff. But it's just great to get out there in front of big crowds and celebrate my language and to normalise diversity within the music arena. So that's the real blessing and what I get really pumped about.
Thank you.
Well, Mitch Tambo's new single, Yugal Yulu-gi, have I said it right?
Yugal Yulu-gi, that's
I love it. It's available everywhere now and it's a banger, and you're going to stick around for the chats?
I am. I'm ready for what's up next.